Hello, I'm KCRA3 meteorologist Dirk Verdorn, and taking a look at the weather pattern here in California. Still lots of sunshine, but the good news is that the marine layer, we have that narrow band of clouds that have popped up along the California coast, and that's really impacted our temperatures here in the Central Valley, especially through the southern Sacramento and northern San Joaquin valleys, as that onshore breeze makes its way in, and we get one branch that goes to the north, the other branch goes to the south, and that really affects temperatures. But the farther away you get from that breeze, the hotter the temperatures will get. So we still have lots of areas that are going to be running in the triple digits. So here's a look at our July temperatures. We've had now eight straight days of triple digit temperatures. And we've had quite a few of those days. You can see from Tuesday, the first Tuesday of the month, to Sunday. So a good 6 days there with temperatures at or above 105 degrees. That's some serious heat. And we are looking at breaking that trend. We'll still maybe see some triple digits today, but it looks like by Tuesday we could see temperatures that stay in the 90s for daytime highs. And the reason why, again, it's that marine layer. It's that delta breeze. Again, it's going to be thickening up overnight tonight. In fact, tomorrow morning we could wake up to a little bit of cloud cover from the marine layer as it blows in overnight. That's going to be with us, but it'll burn off, and we're looking at sunny skies through your Tuesday afternoon. And it's looking sunny all throughout the mountains, through the foothills, but along the coast, yeah, if we're going to San Francisco, it's going to be cool with low cloud cover, and that'll build in again as we go through Tuesday night and into Wednesday morning. But unfortunately, it gets shut down. Look at this. We get a bit of a flow that's coming in from the north that's going to pull out the marine layer, and heat is going to build back into our area as we get into Wednesday afternoon. We're going to see a significant jump in temperatures. Come Thursday, looks like it could get even warmer coming our way. So the overall pattern, what we have is just this little area of low pressure that's off the coast of California right now. You can see the areas of a darker kind of an orange to red color, and then it turns to more the lighter orange color. That's where we have this little disturbance that is out there, and that's helping to bring in that cooler air into the valley. So we'll feel the effects of that through tomorrow, but then high pressure fills back in, and we're looking at temperatures that are going to jump back up into, again, well into the triple digits. And we're looking at temperatures on Thursday, again, upwards of 110 degrees is what we can expect. But after that, it looks like more mild weather starts to move in as we have this long wave trough that starts to develop over the Pacific Northwest. And that in turn is going to help to bring cooler temperatures to Northern California. And this looks like it could happen from this coming weekend through much of next week. So that's some good news. We're going to catch a break from this heat, this oppressive heat that we've had. Your 7-day forecast shows that big jump in temperatures as we go from 98 to 108 degrees from Tuesday into Wednesday, 110 on Thursday, then dropping down to 104 degrees on Friday. And you can see overnights also are going to get very warm. That just tells you that marine layer and the delta breeze is shutting down. And then we have temperatures that start to modify quite a bit more as we get into Saturday and Sunday as it returns with the marine layer and the delta breeze and temperatures in the mid to low 90s. That's a look at your weather. For all your weather needs, make sure you turn to KCRA.